Well, hello guys, Lego Show TV here, and this time we're back with another Minecraft video, and I'm sorry if you guys don't like me doing on the Lego Show TV, but I feel like I don't really need to do another channel, because I feel like Minecraft's kind of a Lego style thing, and because it does have blocks. And today we are doing something different. Yes, we will eventually get back to regular single player survival. But that'll be later after we do 2 episodes of something different and then we get back on track. And, today I want to show you my server. Here is the address.
Thank you, Past Me, for that introduction. Hello, guys. You know, it's me, Lego Show TV, but today I'm going to be doing this intro, and it is going to be 2 channels together. It is for my second channel and this channel. This video is going on both channels. Yes, Minecraft is back for a little bit on the main channel, just a little bit, because it had its beginnings on the main channel. And I am kicking it a little bit retro because this month was 5 years of Ninjago Craft. So, yeah, I said 6 years, but I miscounted, so sorry about that. And looking back at 2014 me, compared to me now, I'm a lot better. And I don't know if I can say that about my building skills, but as for my voice, a lot better. So thank you to 2014 me for, you know, introducing this video. And without further ado, let's get to the surprises for this video. So you may have noticed if you watched my other channel all the way back in, if you watched Lego Show TV all the way back in 2014, you may remember this familiar style of spawn. That's right. It is a recreation of the 2014 spawn. Now, obviously, it's updated and everything. So, yeah, it's a little bit newer style. And things have changed. There are a few changed things from the, you know, original. And because the footage was so bad, I got really bad angles all the way back in 2014 because I did not care about how the video looked at all, apparently. So, yeah. I did not care much about that quality content. But it is back. It has the little pool at the bottom. It's in an extreme hills biome, as good as I could get it. The only things that are not changing, or not the same, I mean, are the drop party machine's gone. There's no Cyrus Borg tower or anything like that. So, yeah. This is a recreation of the faction's main spawn, kind of. It was used for both the main spawn and the faction spawn at the same time. So, yeah. This is the faction spawn. Number one rule here. Raiding is allowed anywhere but spawn. If you use hacks, per ban, no questions asked. Drop down and begin journey. Right here, we have a fox spawner. But in the old version, it was cows, chickens, and wolves, and sheep. We still have the classic enchantment table set up. It's a little bit different in the amount of blocks that are used and stuff like that. But it is still kind of identical. Then we got the end zone, which I still need a label and stuff like that. And then we got over here, we have the little board area where we had the original things. We had the at the time it was Chima stuff, and Bryce wasn't even, I didn't even know who Bryce was at the time. But yeah, a lot of things have changed. You may notice the textures are a little bit different. They updated the textures in 2014, this update, Village and Pillage, the one we are in now, compared to 1.7.10. This is a resource pack. The textures, they actually are updated. This is the older ones. I'm gonna take my resource pack off. This is what it looks like now. This is what it really looks like. And everything. This is actually what it looks like. But I'm using some of the more beta textures from when they were still working on them. So yeah, I really like those better. You go down here, it's the same little thing. Anything goes beyond this point. We can fly back up here. Oh no! In the future, I may do a video where I add the Cyrus Borg Tower and everything back in there. Just for the fun of it. I just didn't feel like doing that today. So, we have a few changes. Obviously, we have me as the owner and Lego and Bryce Films. And we're looking for mods and stuff and admins. So, this is a little bit newer. Ninjago Craft announcement board. For July and August, we hope to reopen soon. The mistakes I made with the 2014 server, or the server originally, I fixed them this time. I've world guarded the whole area. This whole spawn is world guarded for the most part. I don't think I missed a single block, as far as I know. And that was the number one mistake, because I was just learning how to become a server owner and stuff like that. I was just learning how to do that. And here are the rules. No cursing, what I say goes. No hacking, no begging for staff. Rules always report, always respect the owner and co-owner. No griefing, the spawn of course. No asking for op. When owner isn't on, co-owner is in charge. Have fun, Ninja Go. Anyone who doesn't follow them will be banned. No questions asked. We do not tolerate bad players. Banded for real life. Banded for life. Still real suey, but Fadis is banded for life. He's banded for life. So, yeah. And I also want to kick it off with one more retro thing. that you guys may remember. After a couple of refreshes and Tournament of Elements came out, I decided to make a spawn kind of inspired by that. And this is what this is of. This is of a 2015 spawn. You guys may remember it. There's a playlist where you can see these videos of what I'm talking about on my channel. It's called Chima Ninjago Craft Playlist. I have some Minecraft servers that I talked about there. So obviously right here was some rules. This one's empty. This had this. And there's the application room. I realized how bad my spawns were. How uneven they were. So I stayed true to my 2015 me and made it uneven on purpose this time. So yeah. This is going to be where you spawn realistically when you get here. That other one. There's going to be, when you go through this portal, there's going to be a hub that you use Google for games, and you can go to the factions. But yeah, know that this is done on purpose, and stuff like that. So yeah, in this application room, we have Lectern, one of the new Minecraft features that allows you to read a book. This is how you apply. Because I could not get a plugin to work that I would normally use, this is what we have come to. So what you're going to do is you're going to read the lectern. There are 7 pages. I know I spelled that wrong. Help. Helpful tip. Do not beg owner or co-owner to read application. It will not be accepted if you do so. On the next pages are the questions you must answer in a separate book. Read all of them and answer them as you wish. Correctly and stuff. As of now, there are 2 positions open. Mod and admin. Mod roles basically guarding the server when the owner isn't on and doesn't get to do much than that. Admin's role is to guard it as well, but also make sure the mod does right, and the admin can be banned. The admin can ban people for good, while the mod can temp ban. Here's the questions. What are you applying for, mod or admin? Why should we hire you? This is like an actual job, kind of, what an actual job would kind of be. Like, have you had any bad backgrounds with other servers? Can you get on every once in a while? Are you sub delayed or shut to be the most important question in regard to Minecraft? If a hacker comes on, what actions do you take? If for some reason the server shuts off, what do you do? If you answer these nicely, you may get the rank. Setting the ranks up isn't easy, so if you don't exactly get the rank right off, the faction spawn will have the staff labeled as well as this spawn. Contact me via Twitter at this. Contact me via Instagram at this. You are to only contact me if it is a legit emergency, not for something stupid. If you do, you will be punished. Good, done. You take a book out of here, read the questions, write down your questions and your answers, labeled 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever, and then put them in here as such. It's written right there for you, right there. So yeah, that's about it for this video. We're just kind of paying tribute to the past of Ninjago Craft. And I hope to open soon. So, yeah. I hope to, open very soon. Which would be nice. And so, yeah. But I gotta watch out because still hackers around no matter what. And I'm still working out the kinks. There are some bugs in some of the plugins, even though they're new for 1.14. There are still some new bugs that are needing to be worked out, which I bet the people are working on. But that is about it for this video. So maybe expect a part two coming soon when I build the game hub and stuff. But that is about it for this video. Comment, like, and subscribe to LEGO Show TV and Aquatic Let's Plays and Reviews. And for any type of news, every once in a while there will be a Minecraft video on here. But realistically, it's going on Aquatic Land, Aquatic Let's Plays and Reviews. And I will be starting the faction series up again. It'll just be in this newer world. I'm leaving the one with that villager breeder behind because realistically, I'm gonna get tired of playing on that one. So, yeah. So, that's about it for this video. Please comment, like, and subscribe to both channels, and I shall see you next time. Also, turn on notifications. And in September, I will be going to Disney World, so both servers will be offline. Whitelist or not. So, yeah. Please comment, like, and subscribe. See you next time. Goodbye.